Hi, this is Ellie Rango for gamevisualz. What you're going to learn today in this tutorial is how to make a third-person controller camera. So basically what's going to happen is once your character gets far enough from the camera will follow your player. However, you'll be able to see your character from different angles as the character moves around. What I like about this is you can see the animations for your player. It also sets up, I think, well for, sets up nicely for you to see what's going on in the environment. As I take you through this tutorial, I not only explain what I'm doing, I try to explain why I'm doing what I'm doing. So I hope you get a lot out of this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Hi, this is Ali Arango for gamevisualz. Today I want to show you how to set up a third-person camera inside of Unity. So let's get started. Okay, I made another tutorial where I showed you how to bring this character in from Blender, as well as how to set up animations for that character. When I click the play button to preview, you can see the character moves around. The character animates. However, the camera does not follow the character. So that's what we're going to set up. Okay, to have this be set up, we need to make a new C# script. So what we're going to do, down in the Assets panel near the bottom of the screen, we're going to right-click. We're then going to go to Create. Then we're going to select C# script. We're going to name this capital T. Third person camera. So with that done, or when I say done, I meant this with this C# script made, we're going to double click on the C# script, and this opens up Visual Studio. Normally when you double click on a script, you'll go right to that script. If that doesn't happen, what you can do is just go back to Unity, then double click on your script again, then you'll go into the script that you made. Okay, the first thing we want to do is make a variable so that our camera will have information about what it's looking at. So what we're going to do is go up next to this curly bracket. We're going to press enter. And we're going to put in a new variable. And what that variable is, we're going to enter in public, capital T. And Visual Script is trying to help us out. So I'm just going to press the tab key to let it. We're going to put in player. And then in C# we end off a statement with a semicolon, typically. So this public is going to let us see a box inside of Unity. We'll be able to work with what the transform is working with. Okay, what you see here are two functions. Typically when you work with Visual Script, you start off with these two functions. This function here controls what happens once you first start a game. This function right here controls what happens every frame. So what we want to do is look to this void update. What we want to do here is have our camera look at our player. So to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to put in this dot lowercase transform dot capital L. Visual Studio wants to help us out, so I'm like, let it. We'll press the tab key. So look at, we want parentheses player dot position, and we'll go outside of that parentheses, we'll put in a semicolon. Then with that information in, what we want to do is go to File. And then save. Okay, here we are back in Unity. What we want to do is we want to select our camera over in our hierarchy view on the left hand side of the screen. With the main camera selected, we want to go to our third person controller script, left click and drag the script onto our camera. Okay, when you look over to the right-hand side, you can see that there's this spot here that says none. What you want to do is go to the left-hand side of your screen, left-click and drag your player into the spot that says player. Okay, what we want to do now is go up to near the mid-center of our screen, select play. And what we should see is that our camera now aims at the player. So it doesn't follow the player. However, it does aim at the player as the player moves around. Okay, I'm going to select the preview again. We want to set things up so we can aim when we get close to the player, so that if we want, we can aim up. So I'm going to come out of that preview just by selecting the play button near the top middle of the screen. Okay, so let's go back to our script. Okay, so we want to have our camera have the ability to be moved. So as it aims at us, we can aim it up or down. So to do that, what we're going to do is go above our start function. We're going to go underneath our public transform. We're going to make another variable. So this is going to be public, capital V. Vector 3. Typically, if I say Visual Studios, like you can, enter in the code, I'll press tab to have it being Visual Studio enter the code for us. We're going to press space, look. Offset, space, equals. New space, capital V, vector 3. Then we're going to enter in parentheses, 0, comma, space, 1, comma, space, 0, parentheses, and then we'll end this off with a semicolon. Okay, when you're working with vectors in Unity, vector threes, I should say, vector threes work using 3D axes. So typically when you work in 3D, that your axes are X, Y, Z. So when you have a vector three, you see these three numbers here. This first number here is X, the second number is Y, the last number here is Z. So what I mean is this corresponds to X, this corresponds to Y, this corresponds to Z. So what this variable is being set up for is so we can offset our camera by one unit on the Y axis. So to have that work, what we want to do is we want to go to our look at player position here. We want to select in the parentheses. We're going to enter in space, plus space, and then we're going to put in look. Visual Studio wants to help us out, so I'm like, let it. So look offset. This look offset here is the same look offset you see there. Okay, so what we want to do is go to File, and then save our code. Okay, here we are back in Unity, so we'll go up the upper middle screen to preview this. So now the camera is offset so that it looks up. So I'm going to go to the upper middle portion of our screen, then come out of preview. So what we need to do now is we need to have our camera actually follow our player. Okay, here we are back in Visual Studio. There's two things we want to set up. We want to set up so that the camera follows the player once it gets a certain distance away from the player. We also want to set things up so the camera has its own speed. To do this, we need to enter in two new variables. We're going to go up above our start function. We're going to enter in public float distance equals 8 semicolon. We'll also enter in public float camera speed equals 8 semicolon. Typically in Unity, where you see a float, that's basically dealing with a decimal. So with that set up, what we want to do now is we want to look to our void update function. What we want to do is enter in here a vector 3. Just press tab to put that data in. Look, capital P, position equals player dot position. I just press tab to put that in. Plus look offset. So we put in a semicolon to finish that off. Okay, what we want to do now is we just made this new variable. So we're going to replace this information here with the variable we just made. So we're going to enter in here, look, capital P, position. I'll just press tab. So now this code is going to work with this variable here. Okay, so what we want to do now is set up an if statement that once the camera is a certain distance away from the camera will follow the player. So to do that, we're going to go behind the semicolon, press enter, we'll press enter again. We'll put in if parentheses, capital V. Visual Studio wants to help us out, so we'll press tab, let it help us out. Vector 3 dot capital D distance. We'll press tab to put that distance in. Parentheses, this dot transform, just pressing tab to put that in, dot position. Comma. Visual Studio wants to help us out. We want to put in the position, so we'll press tab to put that in. Then what we're going to do is go outside of this parentheses, press space, enter in a greater than sign, then enter in distance. We'll press tab to put that in. We'll go outside of that parentheses, then press enter. Then we'll hold shift, put in the curly bracket. We'll press enter. Inside of this curly bracket, we're going to put in this dot. Oops. This dot transform dot capital T. Translate, so we'll press tab to put that in. Parentheses, 0, comma, 0, space, camera speed. Not that. We want times. Time dot. And I put a little D. Then we want delta time. We'll go outside the parentheses and then put in a semicolon. Okay, we see this here. I forgot to put in a comma. I was wondering why. So we'll put in a comma there. Okay, that should be good. Okay, so what's going on here is we're saying if the, right here, if the camera is further from the player than the distance that we set up here, then we want this to happen, and we want the camera to work on the z-axis. So remember I was telling you about the vector 3? When you see that parentheses, often you'll see the first base, x, y, and then z. So we want the camera to move along the z-axis. Okay, so you want to save your code, so we'll go to the upper left, File, and then Save, so our code is saved. Okay, here we are back in Unity. What we want to do is go to the upper mid-screen, select the Preview button. So now what should happen is when our character moves, the camera follows. So this is working as it should. So I'm just going to go to the preview button to come out of the preview, or play button to come out of that preview. Okay, so that's how you set up a third person camera controller inside of Unity. Actually, I should say that's one way that you set up a third person camera controller. If you want to know more about how to do this, I learned mostly how to do this from Holistic 3D. It's an excellent YouTube channel, so if you want to learn further about the subject, I recommend you check out the Holistic 3D YouTube channel. Okay, guys, that's it for the tutorial. For all of those of you out there who like the videos on this channel and reshare them, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. And if you are new to this channel and you like the videos on this channel, you would like to see more, please subscribe, and thank you for viewing.